will be the second of three videos today. We've got one already out talking about bowl season in college football. Now let's talk some college basketball. We got this past week's recap, so from the 14th to the 20th, and we'll have the preview for this week. The new AP poll is out and stuff like that, so we'll have the preview and stuff for this week out shortly afterwards, or rather, I will. There's no we. But so conference play has ramped up and stuff like that, and one of the biggest casualties of this week, of course, was the Virginia Villanova game getting canceled. So that was going to be a mega weekend, and we still got it in some form, but it wasn't what we expected. Florida has also canceled three more non-conference games. I was assuming they'll just go up ahead and start SEC play soon, due to Keontae Johnson still being in the hospital and stuff like that. I have no idea how that guy is doing, but he was in a coma. Now he's out of a coma. He's responding, doing well. Again, best of luck to him and the Gators basketball team. Now, what Virginia did do this week, or rather this past week, was schedule a game with Gonzaga. We'll talk about that game in the next video in about an hour or so. But Virginia Tech did upset Clemson. Purdue, very, very scrappy, a very strong Purdue team, beat Ohio State. Marquette, they beat a top 10 team again in Creighton. Very not particularly surprising. There is an undefeated team in the Big East that we do need to talk about, but I will talk about them in the next video, of course. San Diego State gets upset by BYU. I don't know how, I don't know why. But, it was crazy. There's also the game on Saturday, the rescheduled Wisconsin-Louisville game, in which Louisville got absolutely mud-stomped by the Badgers. UCF also upsets Florida State. There's a interesting, game going on for UCF this upcoming Saturday as well. Northwestern also upsets Michigan State. Crazy stuff, right? Texas, my Longhorns, they outlast Kate Cunningham and Oklahoma State. We only went by 3 points. And Rutgers is legit. They beat up on Illinois. The Big Ten is going to be tough. It is going to be a tough, tough conference to win. You don't know who's going to win it. Could it be Rutgers? I don't know. Could it be Michigan State? I don't know. Could it be Wisconsin? I don't know. Could it be Illinois? I don't know. Could it be Ohio State? I don't know. Big Ten is going to be as tough as they come this year. So let's talk about the games that I did see this weekend. Let's just get one more out the way real quick that I didn't see, which was Kentucky, North Carolina. It's pretty hilarious that the Wildcats are 1-5. That's all I can say about that. Thursday night, in Kansas, Texas Tech, Big 12 opener for both of these teams. It was a really damn good defensive game, and it's going to be telling to see how these games in the Big 12 are going to go. It's the Big 12 and the Big 10 this year that are looking like the best conferences in college basketball. And it was a really damn good defensive game. Matt McClung dominated the first half. Terrence Shannon in the second for the Red Raiders. And Agbaji, he was the only guy really scoring for Kansas. And there was a lot of phantom charges being called in this game. I mean, it was crazy. Yet somehow Kansas got the W late. They really got it late. It was a really, really good game. Really defensive. I loved every second of it, and we're going to have plenty of these Big 12 play this year. I can tell you that right now. So, what about Saturday? Well, there was also Ohio State-UCLA, but I was not really focused on UCLA-Ohio State as I should have been. Honestly, there was a beating going on in the ACC championship game in football during that same time. So, Ohio State-UCLA, I got the short end of the stick for me. It was a really fun, really close game. I really only paid attention to the end of it. But the big one, number one versus number three, Iowa Gonzaga. And, Luka Garza had a lot of points this game, but this defense, it is rough to look at. They just couldn't put any big shots in there. And Jalen Suggs was off and going. He was scoring, he was blocking, he was getting assists in. Everybody was eating for the Zags. I mean, it was just wow. This looks like the number one team in the country. This looks like they can hang with anybody. And I think, maybe it was because that they haven't played in a couple weeks, but the Bulldogs got a lot of turnovers in this game. We're talking about damn near 20 of them, or it might have been over 20. But on the flip side, they got a lot of offensive rebounds, and that's mostly because Timmy and Kispert are in there inside. But man, Iowa made it respectable again. They couldn't score the big shots. They scored enough, and I mean, Luka Garza still went off and scored a lot of points in this game, but yeah, it was not close. It really wasn't. The score does not indicate how lopsided this game was. Gonzaga had their way with the Iowa Hawkeyes. So there you go. That's week four of the college basketball season. We know some more things. I'll tell you that much. We know some more things, and who knows what's gonna happen as we continue forward in this season. So, see y'all in the next video in about an hour or two, talking about the next set of games, which will be this week. Oh, we got a bunch of goodies this week. Oh,